day today. Get your coffee for you here, and we'll see you that you get on your way. There we go. There you are, Peter. Thank you. We get a lot of customers like Peter who are regulars. But the restaurant business is very competitive. There are a lot of very good people in their industry who are working very hard to make sure their restaurant is the customer's choice. To become the public's favorite takes good food, cleanliness, and good service. Good service involves much more than just getting food from the back line to the customer. It means serving the customer. It means seeing your restaurant as your customer does. Treating the customer in a way that leaves him feeling good about himself, about you, and about Hardee's.
Thank you, and come back to Hardee's.
Very nice suggestive selling, Jim.
Thank you.
Hi, welcome to Hardee's.
Our service procedure on the front line and the drive-through service are designed to maximize our level of service. But good service is more than just following the book. Our service procedures require your enthusiasm, your sincerity, your human touch to bring them to life. These procedures don't deal with handling hamburgers, buns, or condiments. They deal with handling people. We've identified some of the service skills you'll want to keep in mind. The way you look to customers and the way you look at them means a lot. Maintain good eye contact and smile.
Would you like a big cookie with that order?
Yes, please.
Fine.
The way you say something can mean as much as what you say. Speak in a friendly, outgoing way. Know your job, be a good team player, and concentrate. Your customers will know whether you're on the ball. Move quickly.
$3?
If you convey a sense of enthusiasm and urgency about getting the order to your customer, the customer will feel important and will appreciate it. And sell. You're a host, a server, and a salesman. Our cinnamon and raisin biscuits are homemade, so let your customers know we're proud of them. And be sure to tell your customers about any special promotions we may be running. The customer's first impression of Hardee's is formed before he even comes in the door. The way the grounds around your restaurant look can affect a customer's appetite. The times that form lasting impressions of Hardee's in our customers' minds are our moments of truth. The customer's first impression of you is a crucial moment of truth. When the customer arrives, don't wait for him to talk. Smile and greet him. Make him feel welcome. Look pleasant. Remember, you're making a first impression. You'll find that if you learn the names of your regular customers and greet them by name, they'll appreciate it and will remember you, too. Customers are turned off by a greeting that sounds like a memorized speech.
Welcome to Dinko's, home of the Dinko Delight. How may I be of service to you today?
If you vary what you say in your greeting of customers, you'll sound more sincere. Sincerity is one of those things that people can't easily describe, but they know it when they see it. The key to being sincere is to be yourself. Even though we want to smile and greet our customers as soon as they approach the serving counter, it's not always appropriate to ask for their orders right away. Many people will know exactly what they want when they come in. But if you notice the customer gazing at the menu board, give him a minute. Or suggest a sandwich he might like.
Hi, you need some help deciding? How about a big deluxe sandwich and an apple turnover?
What's on a big deluxe?
Okay, you get mayonnaise, pickles.
Suggestive selling can often help the customer. It can encourage him to sample something on our menu he hasn't tried yet. And it builds our business. Now you're ready to take the order. This may be a good time to ask the customer if he plans to eat in the dining room. If you have someone to help you, they'll know right away whether to get a tray or a bag. Other appropriate times are when you smile and greet him, or after you finish taking the order. Pay attention to what the customer says while ordering, so you're sure you're getting the order right.
That'd be a large fry?
Yes.
Suggesting a large size when the order does not specify size is called selling up. Enter the order on your terminal, being sure to clarify sizes. Save any other questions you may have so the customer can keep his train of thought.
Would that be for here?
Yes.
When the customer is through, ask whatever questions you may still have.
Out of five?
If you did not have an opportunity to sell up, suggest something to round out the meal, an add-on, like a big cookie. That's suggestive selling too. Avoid the phrase,
Is that all?
It encourages the customer to stop right there. Suggestive selling is just that, a suggestion. We don't want to turn our customers off by being pushy about it. So limit your suggestions to one sell-up or one add-on. Be positive in your approach, learn the best timing for your suggestions, and as always, be pleasant. One thing to remember is that we never suggestive sell to children. Children are much too susceptible to suggestions and may not realize that we're offering to sell them something, not give it to them. When you total the order, tell the customer the amount due.
Fry and a milk. Okay. That'll be $2.59.
If the customer has his money ready, take it then. If not, begin assembling the order. This accomplishes two things. It's an efficient use of time, and it relieves the customer of being in the uncomfortable position of fumbling for change while you and other customers watch and wait. When the customer gives you money, repeat the amount due and the amount he's given you.
Okay, that'll be $2.59 out of $5.
Place whatever bills the customer gives you across the drawer and leave them there until he acknowledges receipt of his change. There's no room for confusion about how much you were given if it's kept separate from the rest of the money in the cash drawer.
That's 41. 1 and 2.
When making change, be very methodical. Do one thing at a time. It may take a bit longer, but you're less likely to make a mistake. Don't hesitate to ask your manager for help in a situation like this. When receipt of the change is acknowledged, place whatever bills you were given in their proper slots, all facing the same direction, and close the cash drawer. Remember to repeat all to-go orders to be sure you've included everything.
Thank you, and come back and see us.
We began assembling dining room orders by placing a paper tray liner on a clean plastic food tray. The proper order to follow when assembling orders is beverages first, then sandwiches or platters. Move items from the transfer cabinet to the customer's tray, using one hand for each item. Desserts. And then side orders. Be careful not to let cold items touch hot items on the tray. It's best to place sandwiches in the center, side orders such as French fries on one side and drinks on the other side. Whenever possible, keep French fries and hash rounds upright by leaning them against a sandwich box on the tray. When the order is assembled, slide the tray toward the customer with a smile. We close the order with a thank you and an invitation to come back to Hardee's. Of course, the assembly procedure is different for takeout orders, but we still begin by preparing the drinks. If there are two or more drinks to an order, put them in carryout trays. Sometimes, though, a customer will request that they be put in a bag. When that happens, be sure to put the drinks in a bag that will hold them securely, and never put more than 4 drinks in one bag. Be careful not to bag hot and cold drinks together, and not to bag drinks with food. Each cold drink order includes 1 straw. We get a bag open before assembling the order. Open it with your hand, not by popping it. Place the order inside carefully. Don't crush the food. It's best to support the bottom of the bag with one hand and load the food into it from the transfer cabinet with your free hand. Boxed items go in the bag first, wrapped items next, and side orders last. Be sure that French fries and hash rounds are placed upright in the bag and that big cookies and turnovers lie flat. Fold the top of the bag neatly over twice and present the order to the customer with the Hardee's logo facing him. Sometimes a customer will ask that a sandwich be dressed differently than usual. You may need to charge extra for some condiments, so check with your manager. This is called a grill order. Be sure to tell your customer that it'll take a few moments to fill his special request. When the grill order is ready, the control person on the back line will call you by name to tell you. Remember, your customer hears your communication with the people on the back line, so keep it courteous. And don't scream back and forth. Another of your responsibilities in assembling orders for customers is to be sure that everyone who comes in gets food that is fresh. Make sure that what should be hot is hot, and what should be cold is cold. We assure the freshness of our sandwiches by controlling the time we hold them.
Thank you.
We do this by using timing numbers.
Hi, may I take your order, please?
We don't want to serve a sandwich that's been held longer than it should be. The numbers go from 1 to 12 and correspond to the numbers on the face of a clock. Check the number behind a sandwich against the frontline clock or with your watch. If the minute hand is at or past that number, the sandwich must be discarded. Talk to your manager about your restaurant's procedure for discarding food and keeping a record of what is discarded. Sandwiches, of course, are prepared on the back line, but you prepare drinks up front. For soft drinks, get the correct size cup and fill it half full of ice. Always use an ice scoop to protect the cup from being crushed. Then fill the cup to within 1/4 inch of the top, cap it, and serve it with a straw. Follow the same procedure when serving iced tea, but completely fill the cup with ice. Remember to offer sugar or sweetener. For hot tea, fill a 10-ounce hot cup with hot water, cap it, and serve it with a tea bag. Offer the customer sugar or sweetener, lemon, and a stirrer. We use the same 10-ounce hot cup for coffee. Fill it, cap it, and offer the customer cream, sugar, or sweetener, and a stirrer. Ask your manager how your restaurant mixes milkshakes. When serving orange juice, inspect the foil seal. Don't serve the juice if the seal is bulging or broken. A bulging seal is a sign that the juice is spoiled. Also check to see that the juice is thawed. If it is not, don't serve it. After you've inspected the juice, shake it up for the customer and serve it with a straw. Before serving milk, check the discard date that's stamped on the top of the fold of the container. Do not serve milk if it is out of date. One way we measure our service is by the amount of time it takes to fill a customer's order. Service time is measured from the second you total the order until the second the full order is presented to the customer. During breakfast and lunch, our goal is to serve each customer in 45 seconds or less. During peak dinner periods, we aim for a service time of 60 seconds or less. Along with speed goes a sense of urgency about filling the customer's order. Make the customer feel that his order is top priority. Be alert, energetic, and never ignore your customer. Keep your attention toward the front. That lets our customers know we care. Keep in mind that service time is just one component of service. Accuracy and courtesy count just as much as speed. In fact, the three are interrelated. If you fail at one, you can still save the situation. But if you fail 2 out of 3, well, your customer's visit to Hardee's will probably not be remembered fondly. We get a lot of special requests on the front line. For example, a customer may want to use the phone. The phone is behind the counter, so we usually can't offer that courtesy. However, in an emergency, your manager may choose to make a call for a customer. Accidents do happen, and when they do, we have an opportunity to impress our customers with especially good service. When a customer spills something, try to lessen his embarrassment, replace what was dropped without charge, and clean it up right away. Sometimes you'll be asked to give advice or directions. Here, too, you can show good service by being courteous. You'll find that some customers need special assistance. A mother with a baby in one hand and packages from shopping in the other may need your assistance in putting the packages on the counter so she can get to her pocketbook to pay for her order. She may even ask you to warm a baby bottle for her. An elderly customer may need your patience and indulgence, even though there are others waiting impatiently in line. Let compassion and your manager's instructions be your guide in situations like this. Sometimes we're asked to put coffee in a thermos. We can do that. Just charge them as though you had served a cup of coffee. Now, let's review the key points in frontline service. There are 3 components to service: speed, accuracy, and courtesy. The quality of Hardee's service is just as important as the quality of our food. Taking a customer's order involves 5 main goals. Smiling and greeting the customer. Taking the order and making suggestions.
handling the money transaction, assembling the order, and closing the order. Place grill orders first, then assemble the rest of the order. Remember to watch your timing numbers to ensure product quality. Keep hot and cold items separate when bagging orders to go. When presenting a takeout order, tell the customer what's in the bags to be sure the order has been filled properly. And keep our service time goals in mind. 45 seconds or less during breakfast and lunch, 60 seconds or less during peak dinner hours. Most of all, remember, we're not just selling food, we're selling Hardee's service. Our ultimate goal is to give the most efficient and courteous service possible to each and every customer. Now that we've covered the basics of frontline service, we're going to take a look at some special situations. You'll need to know how to handle these when they come up. Waiting on children takes a special knack. Children are very important to Hardee's. Many times they decide where the family will eat. Just like anyone else, children remember where they've been treated well. So service is no less important when your customer is small. Make the child feel just as important as anyone else.
$4.
Don't overlook a child in line thinking that he must be with an adult. When taking an order from a child, bend over the counter a bit if necessary so you can hear better.
Come back to Hardee's. Hi, welcome to Hardee's. Will you be eating here?
And be patient. A child may not have a lot of experience ordering for himself, and he may be nervous. We don't suggestive sell to children. It may confuse them. When you're assembling an order for a child, remember that children can't carry as much as adults. So make it easy on the child. Making change for children requires special care. If the change in the order appears to be more than the child can handle, put the change in a small bag, fold it closed, and write the word change on the bag. And always put a receipt in the bag. As with any customer, thank the child for coming to Hardee's.
And you change 73 cents.
We do our best at Hardee's to keep things running smoothly so our customers don't have to wait. But occasionally there are delays, either because of grill orders or because production of sandwiches has hit a snag on the back line. When that happens, explain the delay to your customer. If you have time, chat with him for a moment. If not, wait on your next customer. If the delay exceeds 5 minutes, let your manager know. Also, call on your manager if there's a complaint you feel uncomfortable handling. A complaining customer must be handled delicately. Try to show concern without admitting fault. Serving the customer is a team effort. So when you have a free moment, see if there are any other employees who need a hand. And when all waiting customers have been served, go to your backup or secondary assignment. Remember to keep your workstation clean. This is something we do routinely as we work. When dealing with customers, you'll learn not to take it personally when your efforts at suggestive selling are rejected. You'll learn not to let one disagreeable customer ruin your whole day. In time, you'll develop your own style of service. We're not all alike. Each of us has a distinctive personality. So be yourself. So remember, the keys to good service are speed, accuracy, courtesy. Your friendly disposition is important to our customers. There are enough hassles in the world, and we want people to feel they can come to us for a break from all that. So smile, make good eye contact, be personable and professional, and give the customer the same kind of service you'd expect if you were in their place.
Hi, Mary. How are you doing today? May I take your order, please?
You know how people respond to your smile on the front line?
Yes.
Well, when you work the drive-through station, people can't see your smile. They have to hear it.
Hear it?
That's right. A smile can be heard. It comes across loud and clear through the tone of your voice. And that smile is a very big part of our drive-through service. That's why we're out here. I want you to listen to Janet as she greets some customers. Now, once you've heard what the drive-through speaker sounds like, you'll have a better idea of what to do to make your voice come through more clearly. Now, when you talk through the speaker, be sure you speak clearly and distinctly. And remember to keep your microphone open from the very first word to the very last. Think of yourself as a radio DJ. Everything you want to communicate has to come through your voice, except your job is a lot easier than that of a DJ because you have the undivided attention of your audience. Okay, here comes a customer now. Now, remember that we have to greet all drive-through customers within 10 seconds of their driving up.
Okay. Hardee's, may I take your order, please?
Yes, I'd like one deluxe, two hamburgers, and salsa.
Did you notice that Janet didn't refer to the customer as sir or ma'am? That's because if you do, you'll often find that you guessed wrong.
Do you have a coupon for that deluxe?
Did you hear that? If there's a coupon promotion going on, find out if the customer has any coupons before you total the order. Then remember to read the order back to the customer to prevent any confusion or errors. And remember what you learned about suggestive selling. It applies just as much here as it does on the front line. Okay, once the order is taken, then tell the customer the amount due and then ask that they drive up to the window. Okay, let's go inside now and look at the next steps.
Great.
Okay. Now, while the customer is driving around, start getting his drinks and group them together on the counter. Be careful not to mix them up. Be sure each one is capped and has a straw. Now, just like on the front line, use a carry-out tray for two or more drinks, or a bag if that's what the customer asks for. Next, assemble all the food and be sure to include all the right condiments. When the customer pulls up to the window, greet him again and this time show him that smile. Let him see it. Then repeat the amount due and take his money.
Hello, your order comes for $3.70, please.
After you make the change, fold the top of the bag neatly over twice. Hand it to the customer with the Hardee's logo facing them. If there's a receipt in the bag, keep it under the bag and give it to the customer with his order if he asks for it. Service time at the drive-thru is measured from the time the customer drives up to the window until the time he's been given his order. It shouldn't take any longer than 30 seconds. There may be as many as four people working the drive-thru station during rushes. With that many people, everybody has to know what's going on if we're going to get anything done. Now, when there are two or more people in the drive-thru station, the first person is the cashier and the order taker. And the second person assembles the food and drink. With three people, the first person is the order taker, the second is the cashier, and the third assembles the food and drinks. Jobs are even more specific when four people are assigned to the drive-thru. The first takes the order, the second gets the drinks, the third assembles the food orders, and the fourth is the cashier. Teamwork is especially important at the drive-thru station, but you've always got to remember the customer. He's the most important person in this transaction, and his needs must be met. If a drive-thru customer gives you a grill order and it's not ready by the time he reaches the serving window, tell him his order's being prepared, collect for the order, and give him his drinks. Now, if it appears that your customer will have to wait longer than 30 seconds and there's a line of cars in back of him, write down a description of the car and ask him to drive to a designated parking space. Explain to him that his order's being prepared, and that he's being asked to move so others in line won't have to wait. Now, unless your customer specifically asks you to, don't deliver a partial food order. See, it's always better if a food order is delivered all at once. Once you've asked a customer to wait, make sure he's not forgotten. When his order is ready, assemble it and have it delivered immediately to his car. Now, it's important that the drive-thru station isn't left unattended. If you have to leave for a minute, let me or the manager on duty know. Now, just like when you're working the front line, if you have any slack time, well, go to your backup or secondary assignments. Okay? Now, let's go over some of the main points about the drive-thru station. Greet your customers within 10 seconds of their arrival at the menu board. Never address customers as ma'am or sir when speaking to them through the speaker. You may be wrong. Make sure your smile is heard. Your personality counts. Always collect the money before handing any food or beverages to a customer. When the drive-thru is staffed by more than one person, do your own job. Then help your fellow workers as necessary to speed drive-thru service. Always give the customer straws, napkins, and other condiments with their drive-thru order. And remember, our goal is to serve drive-thru customers within 30 seconds of their arrival at the drive-thru window, even in peak periods.
Now, do you think you've got all that?
Yeah, I think so. It's a lot like running the front line.
Yes, it is. And there are a few extra things to keep in mind. And to help you remember, here's a memory jogger for the drive-thru service.
Thanks.
Now I want you to work with Janet. She's going to be able to help you and answer any questions you may have.
Okay.
Well, sounds like you got your first drive-thru customer.
Well, here goes.
Good luck.
Hi, welcome to Hardee's. May I help you?